jazz is being able to improvise something different each time it's played, making it sound good every time but different. And it has also a special feeling. You can call it a groove or a swing. There are many terms you can use, but it's also the thing about it is that for me, explaining music is very touchy, because music is a language of its own, you know, and each type of music has its own language. So it's very difficult to translate music into words. Since 1980, I've been studying composition. It's something that I need to do. I like surprising myself, and I said, wow, I didn't know I could do that, you know. That's a nice feeling.
He is extremely diligent and learned how to write, how to compose, how to orchestrate. And from those meager beginnings as a composer, Tony has grown to be really one of my favorite composers. He's fantastic. I mean, songs like Sister Cheryl, which we're playing for this show, that's one of my favorite songs. And it's a song that almost brings me to tears when I hear it. There's something that's very haunting about it.
Thank you.
there certainly seemed to be a much greater interest in jazz, similar to the kind of interest in jazz in the 60s and before. That seems to be happening today, and I'm glad to see it. I'm especially glad to see more young, talented, vibrant jazz musicians emerging today. And they have such incredible facility, not just technique, but it's as though somehow they have the experience of much older people.